Très bien, thank you very much. Effectively, the problem is with when men and women are living together and they have, as example, a house, and the house is in the name of the husband because he was the chief of the family. And then when there is divorce, after 20 years or 30 years or something like that, woman can go out, as we say in Morocco, with his hand on his head, like that, with nothing. And the actual law tried to find a solution. And this point was object of a very hard polemic, because men were very afraid.
Very scared, very
Very
concerned.
scared, because they say you are going to marry with a girl only one day, and she is going to take the half of all what you have. And there was a lot of ideas like that, who showed that men were very scared about that. And in the beginning, there was the project to make that men and women who have lived together can share half all what they have. Ce qu'ils ont acquis, what they have win into the period of wife of a wedding. But it was not accepted by men, and there was a changement, and they have done that. All what is of the woman stay of the woman, all what is of the man stay of the man, but they can have a contract to say what is the kind of relationship they want to have. They can say, we want to have half of all what we are going to buy in our wedding period, or we can have 30%, 70%, or we want everyone to be independent. They have a choice, the way of sharing their what they own, and they take in account that in some region, like Sousse, like you said, that there is a tradition to give a compensation to the woman that have been working a lot of years into the family. Even if she don't win money, she do the education of children, and she do a lot of things. And so there was a tradition to recognize the right of women. And in the law, actually, they said that the judge can evaluate, sorry, can evaluate the what is the part of the bringing of the woman into the what the family own. And a lot of men said that they are afraid to be abused, that women take more than. There is something like that, but I think that now confidence is coming back, because it is natural that when there is a change, a very important change in the family life, it is natural that people are afraid, because they say they don't know what is going to happen with the new family code. But can I tell you a joke? Because they ask one man, what do you think about family code? He said, ah, family code? Oh, for my daughter, it is wonderful. But with my wife, they have been very, very hard. Very hard. C'est bien pour sa fille, mais c'est difficile pour sa femme.
Okay.
Could you please give us your name?
Sure.
Thank
sure.
you.
My name is Mohammed Ali Lutfi. I am a student here at American University International Development Program. If you'd allow me, I would ask my question in English and Arabic. My question is, I'm so impressed about the progress that has been happening in Morocco in terms of family law. And you mentioned briefly how Morocco is trying to ensure rights for disabled women. I would like to understand more, or have more idea about what's been happening with disabled women under the family law. especially that we know in the Arab world and many developing countries how women with disabilities are being segregated because of their disability and because of their gender. In Arabic, I would like to say, تحدثني عن قانون العائلة في المغرب وذكرت بشكل مختصر وقع النساء المعوقات ونعلم أن في المغرب العربي أو في العالم العربي والعالم والدول العالم الثالث واقع أن هناك واقع سيء للمرأة المعوقة بسبب الإعاقة بسبب بسبب الجنس فأود لو تتحدثي بشكل أكثر تفصيلي عن هذا الموضوع. And I have a second question if you allow me. Okay, how would you convince official people, the government, about the economic rights of women, and how would this have an adding value to the economic growth of the country? سؤالي بالعربية كيف بإمكاننا إقناع الحكومات في دول العالم الثالث بأن هناك إضافة ممكن أن تحدث فيما عندما نتحدث عن حقوق المرأة وأن هذا الموضوع سيحدث تقدم اقتصادي لدول العالم الثالث شكرا Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your first question. I would like to say to tell you that I didn't speak a lot about my ministry, but I have in charge women and the children and the aged people and disabled people and poor and excluded people. So it is a lot of people, but one of my strategic acts of my ministry is the situation of disabled people in general. And we have launched a process of discussing a new draft of a bill, of law, to pour réglementer, to regulate the situation of disabled people from an approach of human rights, because we don't want we want to make a rupture with the approach of qualitative approach. That considered that they are poor people, disabled, and they should have something like that. No, it's not our approach. It is an approach of human rights that considered that disabled people in Morocco are 5% of the population, and men and all women, they have rights. They have rights, and the state can't ignore. Can ignore the rights of these people, and especially there is four axes of work for health rights of these people, for scholarship of these children who needs a special approach, and also with labor access to work of these people, and the fourth it is the accessibilities. The possibility, you know, accessibility, like in the French, accessibilities of, and there was a very big meeting with the, of concertation with the association that work in the area of disabled people, and just recently, less than 1 week, I have a very big festival of people disabled, of children. About the item of for scholar integration of children disabled into the school, and there is a lot of activities that have been organized in the country about the situation of people disabled. You are right, Mr. Mohamed Ali Lutfi. You are right when you say that women disability is a victim of two kind of discrimination. First, discrimination because she is disabled, and second, because she is a woman, and she is most of the time she can.